Now we will study the theories of failure for brittle materials, and these theories of failures are also known as fracture criteria, because unlike the case of ductile materials, we don't have a well defined yield point. So we use ultimate tensile stress or ultimate compressive stress as a limiting value or the maximum value. And the failure here basically means complete fracture or rupture of the component into two or more parts. Therefore, the word fracture criteria. In this, we use three theories. One is maximum normal stress theory, which is also known as Rankine's theory. And then we study brittle Kolb-Mohr theory, which is similar to the ductile Kolb-Mohr theory that we studied earlier. And then we study modified Mohr theory, which is the modifications to the brittle Kolb-Mohr theory. The first theory is the simplest one. It's called maximum normal stress theory. In this theory, this theory is also known as Rankine's theory, as we discussed already. The basic idea behind maximum normal stress theory is failure or fracture occurs whenever one of the three principal stresses equals or exceeds the strength. Okay, so here strength basically means the maximum normal stress of the material at the time of its failure in tensile test or in compression test. So as we already seen, so the strength in case of tensile test is sigma ut, and strength in case of compressive stress is sigma uc. These are the ultimate tensile strength and ultimate compressive strength. So what you have to do is, we have to compare one of the principal stresses, the maximum one, with this strength. If this is a maximum stress, the positive value, if it is more than the ultimate tensile strength, the failure has occurred. Or the least value, if it is smaller than the minus sigma uc, it means the component has failed. So for example, if you plot this on a number line, let us say you have got number line 0. So this value is sigma ut and this value is sigma uc. Let us take this is minus 300 and let me take this as 250. Okay. So because these are uneven materials, the strength will be different. So tensile strength is 250 whereas compressive strength is 300. So therefore you return minus 300. So for example, in the problem, we have solved and found out the principal stress to be some sigma 1, sigma 2 and sigma 3. So we will take the maximum among them and compare whether it is falling within this range. That is, if it has crossed 250, if it is more than 250 or if it is less than 300, okay, then it is falling outside this safe region. So then we say component has failed. So that is the meaning. So for example, if you got a value of say minus 320, okay, this minus 320 is less than minus 300. So it is lying outside this safe zone. Hence we say component has failed. Okay. Or if at all the stress happens to be, let's say 255, then this is again more than 250 and it is falling outside the safe region. So the failure occurs whenever the stress, one of the principal stresses, is beyond this safe zone. What is this safe zone? From minus sigma uc to plus ut. So that is the basic idea behind this maximum normal stress theory. If at all you want to use a design equation for it, you just have to replace the ultimate tensile strength with the divided by the number n, that is factor of safety, or ultimate compressive strength divided by the factor of safety. And as we already discussed, strength basically means either ultimate tensile strength or ultimate compressive strength. So and again, when you are doing a 2D stress case, you should be careful enough to remember that sigma c, that is out of plane stress, out of plane principal stress, should not be neglected. So therefore, you should arrange accordingly and then use the maximum normal stress theory. And it is to be remembered that because we are using uneven material, so we need to check in both the directions. So that means we have to check the first equation. The maximum stress should be, if for safety, it should be less than sigma ut by n, or the minimum, this should be sigma 3. This sigma 3, the minimum value should not be, or should be within the sigma uc by n for material to be safe. Okay, just like the previous case. So earlier we wrote this to be sigma ut, right? Now it will write sigma ut by n. This will be sigma uc by n. So if the stress value lies within this, then the component is safe. If it is crossing this, then it is failed. That's the idea behind maximum normal stress theory. It is relatively simpler. Okay, if you want to plot that, okay, for example, for 2D case, 2D case we will get either sigma A or sigma B. Okay, there are two possibilities. So sigma A, if it is positive, okay, it should lie, it should be below sigma A. If it is negative, it should be greater than sigma UC. Similarly is the case for sigma B. So here is the limit. So sigma A for safety should be less than this maximum value sigma UT, and it should be more than sigma UC. Similarly, the B component, okay, the B stress, if it is tensile, okay, let us say B is positive, then it should be less than sigma UT. And if sigma B happens to be a negative compressive stress, that should be smaller than minus sigma UC, so as to be safe. So that when you take all these equations, you will get a plot something like this. The second theory that we study for brittle material is brittle Coulomb-Mohr theory. So this theory is almost identical to the Coulomb-Mohr theory, that is ductile Coulomb-Mohr theory that you have studied earlier. Okay, that concept is extended to this brittle materials and we call it as brittle Coulomb-Mohr theory. So there we used yield point as the limiting value or the maximum value. Here we will be using ultimate compressive stress as the limiting value or maximum value. A special attention is to be given to this modulus sign, because sometimes the sigma UC may be given as minus 300 or so. So what we should do is we have to take the modulus and use that with 300 without signature in these equations. So this modulus or the absolute symbol is to basically remove the effect of sign and substitute in this equation. So the equation remains same, that is sigma 1 by sigma ut minus sigma 3 by sigma u is equal to 1. So if you want to convert this into design equation, you just divide the 1 by n, where n is equal to factor of safety. Okay, and another important point to be remembered here is the sigma 1 here always represents the maximum principal stress, and sigma 3 represents the minimum principal stress. For example, if the stress, three stresses founded from experiments are something, from the calculations are, say 0 greater than minus 30 is greater than, say, minus 50. So if this sigma A, that is minus 30 and minus 50 are obtained from the previous equations, and this in this case the 0 will become sigma 1 and minus 50 will become sigma 3. So in the equations of brittle Coulomb theory, so you have to substitute 0 for sigma 1 and minus 50 for sigma 3. So that's an important point, that out of plane principal stress sigma c is equal to 0 should not be neglected, and that should be always considered while using these equations. That's what you have seen. The three possible cases have been listed here. So when both are tensile, this case sigma A is greater than sigma B is greater than 0. One of them may be tensile and other may be compression, other may be in compression, or both may be in compression. So all possible scenarios are given here. However, the basic idea still remains same. Sigma 1 is always a maximum value and sigma 3 is always the minimum value to be substituted in brittle Coulomb-Mohr theory. So now we have studied both the maximum normal stress theory and Coulomb-Mohr theory for brittle materials. So as you can see from this diagram, the Coulomb-Mohr theory is found to be more conservative. Okay, so the dashed line is basically, so the brittle Coulomb-Mohr theory is very conservative. Experimental values are shown here. So to take care of this effect, we make a modification, and modified theory will become modified Morse theory. So what is this modified Morse theory? Here we'll explain this in terms of three possible scenarios. So here we'll restrict our understanding, our theory explanation to 2D stress case only. So when you solve the problem, when you solve to get the principal stresses for 2D case, you will have sigma A, sigma B, and 0 is also there. So with these three values, we'll discuss with each possible scenario. Let's take the maximum among these two. So among sigma A and sigma B, let us take sigma A is the maximum. When sigma is the maximum and it is tensile, let us say, when it is tensile, it is just like the maximum normal stress theory. So you can write the equations for modified Mohr as sigma A is equal to sigma UT by N. Okay, now if it is second case, okay, let's stop. Both the maximum normal stress theory and Coulomb Mohr theory are well accepted for brittle materials. However, it is found that these are more conservative, especially the Coulomb Mohr theory is more conservative in nature. As you can see from this diagram, the dashed line, this line represents brittle Coulomb Mohr theory, and the actual experiment values are shown as this marked circles. Okay, so this is your experimental value. So brittle Coulomb Mohr theory is more conservative in nature, that is unnecessarily gives more safer values. Suppose if failure is to occur at 300, it may give a very large, it says the failure occurs as 200 itself. So unnecessarily we are wasting the material. So to avoid this over conservativeness, we make some modifications based on the experimental data, and that modification results into a new theory called modified Mohr theory. So in modified Mohr theory, we'll restrict our attention to only 2D stress case. Okay, let us take when we find the principal stresses, let sigma A and sigma B the principal stress, and 0 is anyway there. So we have three principal stresses, two calculated from the equations dealt earlier. Now let sigma A be the bigger among these two. So we'll keep 0 outside. For the timing, we'll take sigma A and maximum among them as sigma A. And sigma A is a maximum among these two. And if it happens to be tensile, okay, when both are tensile, they're positive. So then you can take sigma A is equal to SUT by N, which is nothing but maximum normal stress theory only. Same equation that we used earlier, which remains same for this also. So when you go to the second case where both are compressive, okay. For example, if it say we have got minus 20 and minus 30. Okay, in this minus 20 is bigger. Okay. However, the actual failure is determined by this minus 30. So numerically bigger value. So this will be your sigma B. Okay. So even though it is minus 20 is bigger, but numerically it's minus 30 which is bigger. Therefore, sigma B should be used for the computation of factor of safety. So here it is. So sigma B is written as minus sigma SUC by N. SUC is nothing but sigma UC only. Now the question is, this is clear basically. So when both are in tensile, so you take the positive maximum. Okay, let me repeat. When both are in tension, you take the positive maximum as the parameter. When both are in compression, you take the negative maximum, that is numerically maximum in the negative direction as a parameter. So when they are, one of them is either tensile, another one is compression, then small modifications required. So there are two possibilities. If the magnitude of A is greater than magnitude of B, then you should use sigma A is equal to sigma UT by N. So like the earlier case. So only difference that comes is in the second case, when the magnitude of A is less than the magnitude of B. So in that case, we will use this equation. This equation is nothing but the similar equation can be derived from ductile column Mohr's theory that we have done already. Only thing is we have made some modifications here. If you look at the diagram here, earlier the brittle column theory represented the equations for this line, the dotted line, whereas the modified Mohr theory represents the equation for this line. This line is more closer to the experimental values. So if you are able to do that, then we can solve the problem based on the modified Mohr theory. So only variation is in the fourth quadrant, which is to take care of the experimental values.